Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. Well, I have Chromecast audio here in my home and I'm gonna get it set up for you right away. First thing I'm gonna do, get it unboxed, show you what's inside the box, and then of course we're gonna go through the full setup process, and by the end of this video, you'll know how to set up your full Chromecast audio system using multiple Google Homes if you have them in the home, and how to cast to multiple speakers at the same time. All right, well, let's get the Chromecast audio opened up. The box itself is quite small. There's not a lot to it. There is some explanation of what you can do with the product, which is essentially cast to speakers. Now, there's a small pamphlet inside, but ultimately you just want to open up, get in the box, and see what you're getting here. You're going to get the Chromecast dongle itself, a small 5 or 6 inch long 3.5 millimeter stereo cable, and then the power adapter and power adapter cable. Now all you do is you plug in the 3.5 millimeter cable into the port on the Chromecast audio, and then you do the same with the USB connector for your power. Then you're essentially ready to go. Once you plug it in, there is a little flashing light on the side, but that's really your only indication that it's actually on. From there, you need to grab your little speaker, make sure it has the small 3.5 millimeter aux port, go ahead and plug it in, and you're completely set up. Now, moving on to the setup process, one thing I'll just show you quickly, now that you have that plugged in, your Chromecast will show up in your Wi-Fi network. Don't connect to that, but it is there. It's a good check for you. Now head into your Google Home application. Once you're in there, you're going to notice right away one device was found. If you don't get this, there's a couple other routes for you to go. You can actually go to your browser on your phone or on any device in your home and go to chromecast.com/setup. Now on a phone, it just redirects you back to the Google Home application. So I'm just going to head back in there, and top right, you do have a devices tab. So go ahead, tap on that. And again, you see the capability to set up. But if you didn't have that, there's add new device at the bottom. So I'm just going to tap on setup, and you can see that it begins the connection process instantaneously, and you get that sound for you to confirm. Now, once you've done that, you have to confirm where it is in your home, and that will actually name the device initially. Then you have to choose your Wi-Fi network. Now, keep in mind, I have my Wi-Fi network already set up in my home. If you didn't have this, you'd be being asked for a password right now. That's all you'd have to put in, and then it would connect to the Wi-Fi. So my Chromecast audio is now connected to my home Wi-Fi, and it's now connected to this application. So we're just gonna link it to our Google account now, and we're almost done is what they're saying. One thing here, I'm not gonna show you how to connect or set up an account with Google Play Music or Spotify or whatever music service you wanna use. Now there's a short update process. You don't really have to do anything there, you just have to wait. And now you're ready to go. Now Google will run you through a quick tutorial. They actually let you play a sample clip here. Now I'm gonna use the TuneIn service. Just gonna hit play on there, and they show you up top right, that's the cast button. So that's what you're looking for within any of the applications. Now you can see the basement speaker. That's the name that it was given because I chose the location as my basement. That's what it's named it off the top. You can always change that later. So I'm going to choose basement speaker, and you'll hear the connection.
All right, let's go back out there. Tom Hamilton has the play-by-play, potential tying run at third, one down in the bottom of the ninth. Royals leading the Tribe 4-3.
The set, the pitch. Swung at, line drive to right center. It gets down, up by a diving Orlando. It'll go to the wall. Martinez scores the tying run. Lindor around second.
The tutorial now is complete, and back in our Google Home application, I'm actually going to tap on devices up top right, and I'm going to scroll down till I find my basement speaker. Now, you note the little blue thing there that says enable voice control and more. I'm going to tap on that, and you're not actually enabling voice control, so keep that in mind, but I'm going to hit yes, I'm in. And what that does is that lets me use it in my account and therefore in services like Google Play Music or Spotify. Now, I can tap on the three dots there. You get a settings. You can head in. You can rename the device if you want. You've got an equalizer, so some control. You can turn on and off guest mode if you want people to be able to cast to that device when they come onto your Wi-Fi at home. And then, of course, I always like signing up for the preview program just to make sure I get any updates to my device. I'm just going to go back to the devices screen, and I'm going to tap the three little dots up at the top right, and I'm going to hit Create Group. Now, I can choose all of my Google devices here if I'd like to create a group. I'm going to call this the full trio. It has my Google Home Mini, my full-size Google Home, and the basement speaker. And of course, the setting down at the bottom, this is really important, make sure that that's on here before you hit save. This setting ensures that this group is available on applications or other pieces of software where you can cast. So that includes Google Play Music or Spotify. So there you go, I have my full trio group. Of course, I could edit the group or delete it or whatever I want to do. I could take speakers in and out of that as we go here. So basically, we're all set up. I'm going to get set up for a demo. And we're going to go into Google Play Music. That's what I have set up. You can see the cast icon top right in the application. I've just hit that. And you can see the full trio group that I'm going to tap on. Now, the connection is complete to all three of my speakers that you saw me choose. And I'm going to start some royalty-free music so that I don't have to mute this out on you. You can see right away that there's control for audio on all three of the speakers independently, or you can control them from the application or from your phone directly.
This first track is a brief introduction to this meditation CD and how to use it.
Once you are acquainted with the guided meditation practice,
feel free to skip directly to track 2 of the CD to begin your iRest practice. iRest is a 4,000-year-old form of...
There it was. I just turned it all down using the buttons on my phone. Finally, I'm going to show you a demo on how to voice control this full group.
Play royalty-free music on full trio.
Sure, royalty-free music from Google Play Music. Playing on full trio.